Yeah, Soundtrack Saturday in the building. What up? Let's get right to it, man. We got a film called He Got Game. 1998, this comes out. You got Spike Lee, the director. Y'all know Spike. Starring Denzel Washington and Ray Allen is his counterpart in this movie, which was very even shocking to me at that time to see Denzel Washington and Ray Allen in a movie. But this was brilliant. Only Spike Lee could put this together. Also has you got Rosario Dawson in it, young Rosario Dawson. Yeah, Rick Fox pops up in this movie. A lot of cool people pop up. This is a movie about Ray Allen. It's kind of loosely based on his life. He's like the basketball phenom, and Denzel Washington plays his father, who was a basketball guy in his own right, but he was a street dude. So he's locked up most of the movie, but then he comes out. And I'm not gonna give up the whole story. Y'all should watch it. It's a good movie. And Ray Allen is like the star. Ray Allen has most of the scenes, and he's just a college kid who's like literally picking which college he wants to go to and dealing with just all of the pressure that comes, you know, when you're a young talent and everybody, you know, see you about to make it out of the hood. It was released under Def Jam. And from the looks of it, this is basically like a Public Enemy album. I don't know. I guess Spike Lee chose to just use Public Enemy. He's like, I want y'all to do the album. And see, that's how soundtracks really used to be back in the day. It wasn't a whole lot of bunch of, you know, a bunch of artists. It started with just one composer, one artist. They say, I want your take on this movie. Obviously, you got the Hit Squad producing on here. They say the album didn't do very well, but I don't be the judge of that.
Damn, back again, on track again. 2G around the bend, some of y'all black again. It got dark, on your mark, get set. Out of sight, out of mind. Hypocrites forget, like marionettes. Dreams in the back, like nets. The chosen one, who fucking laughed himself to death. Lack of rhymes, meaningless punchlines. Battle for your mind, like Israel and Palestine. Good news, it's a fucking hard ass time.
This first track, you got Master Killer. Whoever, I've never really heard of Master Killer. He's a member of Wu-Tang, but he must be the deep cousin of Wu-Tang. Master Killer. I'm trying to remember who this nigga is. I'm sure y'all probably know super Wu-Tang fans. He's cool. I don't care for his rap style. I could tell he's eating on this, but it's like, and then you got Chuck D coming right after him, which is Chuck is he's a it's a it's later in his career right here. Then he don't have the same stick on this beat that I'm used to hearing from Chuck D.
Us for missing us for mad years. One love, yo. Yeah, that's right. He's got game. PE 1998.
If man is the father of the sun, is the center of the earth, in the middle of the universe, then why is this verse coming six times rehearsed? Don't freestyle much, but I write them like such.
Word.
Amongst the fiends controlled by the screens, what does it all mean? All this shit I've seen. Human beings screaming vocal javelin, sign of a local nigga unraveling.
So when I heard the sample, I got excited. I was like, oh, they might take me somewhere. I like that. Boom. I forget what group back in the day fucking made that song, but shout out to y'all. But they got on this joint, Chuck D just talking. He just preaching now. He's not even trying to rap no more. He's like, I'm not gonna rap to these drums. I'm just gonna say the word to these young niggas. Chuck can do that. We'll sit down and listen to what he got to say. He's saying some, thought-provoking shit, but it's like, this record is terrible. The hook is terrible.
I hope this rock gets you in time and space. Come to a different place where you hear spiritual, lyrical knowledge in your face to face, like welfare. In these rappers' lyrics, they need help, yeah. Does KRS represent heaven? Hell yeah. Let me take you elsewhere. Where you stand is a curse there, for sure. Unless you're mature, grow up. If you're immature, then you're living sinister. You reject the words of the minister. You better get with your Quran or Bible. You won't be living long if you're living idle. The teacher, that's my title.
This beat is like everybody gather around the mystic is about to tell the story. It's KRS-One. He's the teacher. He teaches you. So when you show up to KRS song, you need pen and paper and pad. Like, you're not gonna get it initially. He's teaching the college courses at MIT, on his records. He's a philosopher. This is what he does.
Now this is that fly shit. The joint dice shit makes you platinum shit that make you so sick. Life of lifetime takes just got the six, they make you split. bigger money stack, a larger pack, new faking jack.
You get Flavor Flav, the flavor of love. It's a reason why Flav don't rap. They cleared the floor for Flav on this, though. They was like, Flav, you got your own record, bro. And Flav was like, yeah, let me. He's just an energy guy. He's the hype man. He's the fun. You know, he's the physical representation of the fun of this group. Because they were so hardcore, they needed a fucking just bug out character of the group that didn't take himself as serious as everybody in the group. So I can't stand this song, though. You just let Flav take the reins?
Crystal ball, I prophesize what was on the horizon and forewarned y'all. Is it any wonder what kind of ground you going under? A September into the March Madness, remember? You never heard of murder ticket, for example. Unsolved mystery, life lost in the funk sample. Into the bandwagon, bragging, hanging banners, clearing the way for younger MCs and new hammers. What was criticized 6 years back is now back in New York on the jersey, front and back, boy.
At first, I didn't think I was like the beat, but I really do like this beat. The beat grows on you. It's kind of jiggy, but they treating this beat like it's a fucking, like it's one of those audiobooks or something. Like they recording for audiobooks. Sounds like somebody put the wrong audio track on the beat. They're like, damn, I meant to put that on the audiobook and put the rhymes on the. He don't need a beat. Chuck is like the old dude who fathered this shit. And now he's around, so you kind of let him get away with mostly anything. I think they saved this record for me. They saved it with the hook, because I really do like the hook. It's very catchy. Flav sound good coming in there supporting.
To rise to another level, speaking to the kind of refined mind, divine evil. I speak no evil, I hear no evil. I see no equal to the felonated madness. Sad at this mess.
All right, are you ready?
Sad at this mess.
Look around, what do you see? Can you see what I can see? Hard to live without we. Catching hell without he.
This beat is interesting. You know, I don't hate it. I don't love it. I'm somewhere in the middle right now, coasting. Chuck D, you know, he's a shifty one that day. You can't really catch him sometimes. It's like he runs away from you on the record. At least on this one. Old Chuck is a little different, but it's like leaving breadcrumbs and making you chase him around on a beat. Even he's making the beat do that. He's not even staying on the beat. He's ahead of it. He'll go below it. He tries things. I guess that's just his style. You never gonna know where he coming from.
Revelation.
Revelation.
And all in me.
We all approaching what could be Earth's last battle. The war fever is on the rise. The lives of many are in the hands of fate.
It's more spoken word than anything. Very much so the brother on the corner, street corner, just spitting out knowledge, like just spilling their heart out. It's like just a monologue of knowledge and facts that they've accumulated in their head. I see niggas do this all the time. They just stand out outside and just start talking. And nobody interrupts them. Nobody asks a question. They just listen, and that's kind of what this is. You gotta approach this off your Malcolm X. You know, you gotta approach this like a student. You can't be approaching this particular album just I'm trying to party. You know, because that's not what you're about to get. And Chuck D sounds like he's like, let me show you I'm still Chuck in here. He's like, yeah, I'm on some like Bible talk shit, but let me show you I can get busy.
The way this goes down is simple. From this day forth, anything dealing with rap, stay off. It's the playoffs, no payoffs, strictly skills. If your brain's the same, then stick to your deals. In this field, ain't about selling the mill with the run of the mill. So just be telling the real. It ain't like a third time felon's appeal. Till a god schools them and tells them the deal.
Drums are cool. The overall pockets of this song, I don't care for. I'm good on it. The hook is shot weak to me. I don't know, man. This album is having a tough go.
Come back. The color might be green, but it's also black. Also black. Red, I know many heads that spent bloodshed. Cursed in converses, dead in pro-feds. Not every time Dick Harry or Joe Smith skipped the small beans, ponies, and K-Swiss. High school and college coaches getting dollars with kickbacks and scholarships. Them slave shit, huh?
This is some shit. Yeah. This is some ass. And I mean, I'm an upbeat ass nigga. I don't I'm not gonna just call some music some ass, but this is like, I don't even know if Spike listened to this motherfucker. I think he just gave them niggas the keys and was like, do what y'all gonna do.
Now here's the pop, turn around jumper, hits the rim, bounce away, the new slave trade. Man job, 6 feet five, but juvenile, thin line between getting bucks and getting wild. Brooklyn style, 100,000 miles, parquet tiles, leaving ankles broke in a pile. Son got a ticket to fly, he can make it if he try, to the sky like a Coney Island ride.
Man, they on a roll of whackness. I can't even sugarcoat that shit. I feel like this was a bunch of throwaways. And they just called it an album. It was like, yeah, just use all of these songs that we don't, you know. So far, it's just been one song that I fuck with. And it took a fight in my soul to fuck with it. Just wild. And Jesus is Ray Allen's name in the movie. Jesus Shuttlesworth. And, you know, they hyped him up like that. You know, like everybody wanted him. So I guess this is a play on how basketball is the revolution. Like I said, he says deep shit. But he don't give a fuck about the song.
Oh, get that shit, G. Nothing. Yeah.
So, black gold, one strong buck to the Milwaukee Bucks. $4 million. Just kill him off the street so he don't get bucked. Super agent to the rescue so he won't get fucked. Run nigga, run to the auction block. But you can't pledge allegiance to the block. This buck right here is the right kind of stock for sale, for passing. The right kind of rock. Yeah.
And I don't like Chuck on this because Chuck is trying to do like a different flow. He trying to keep up with this like newer fucking 2000 beat they done sent to this nigga. Talking about, you know, how they use, you know, certain black players to market them as stars and then basically just use their likeness up and then be done with them. Talking about the strategic planning behind it, the control of it. This is more true to the movie with the content, but the song is just ass.
Check it. Say it takes two to tango, but a crew to bang yo. Superstar shoot out overtime at the Rango. Clear out the box out, practice at the range yo. Get the D to step back unless they beat the range yo. Rain me by somebody dope to chisel. Rally to miss her. Money earner is a horn burner.
Okay, now this sounds like where Chuck should be. This sounds like what Chuck should be doing. You see it. It's easy. It's effortless for him to just do him naturally on a beat like this. Yes, I like this. And I like Chuck on this. Finally. It's been killing me to like find a record this good. I don't like to hear shitty records. There's been a lot of me. The wrap up on this is, if you never heard this one, you really ain't missed nothing. I see why I didn't do very well. You know, unfortunately, it's only two songs on here that I say check out. Is Your God a Dog? That's a dope record. It grew on me. I had to fight it a little bit, but it got me. And then that last record, Go Cat Go, I think that was his best lyrical performance and best like song he put together on this. Sometimes you get a dub. They can't all be bangers, right? They can't all, you know, can't knock them all out the park. It just seemed like they brought a bunch of B-sides to an album, which is not a good idea. But I guess this was their way of getting the music out and making a profit of it. So I hope they got their money and did their thing. Shout out to Public Enemy. And go look at the movie. The movie is way better than this album. Do it tonight. Make it movie night. All right. I'm out. Enjoy your weekend. We in and out. I'll see y'all Monday. That's it for Soundtrack Saturday.